What's up, YouTube? I think this is gonna work. Not sure. Not sure, you guys. I'm in my PJs again, because that's how I roll. I like this. I like the way they feel. Alright. So. I'm gonna move my plants to a different area for this video so that I can get the right part of my body in it. Alright, so let me break it down. If you're wanting to learn telekinesis, you're gonna want to learn this exercise. If you're going to want to learn levitating, you're going to want to learn this exercise. If you're going to want to learn anything really to do with energy, you're going to want to learn this. Like, it's not necessary. I know other people have their own methods and techniques, but this one really helped me, and so I want to share it with you. All right? And basically, I'm just going to be breathing, and when I breathe in, I'm going to expand my lower abdomen, and you're going to want to find something that you can put on your abdomen. It's not necessary, all right, not at all, but I'm going to use a weight on my abdomen, and so I'm taking my Oregon plate. I don't know how much this weighs. It's got a decent little weight to it. You can use a book or a plate or really anything. You don't have to use anything if you don't want to. But it's nice to have, because then you can tell when your abdomen's rising and when it's falling. All right, and it's recommended to do this for like 3 minutes a day, twice a day. This breathing technique, you can do it more or less, you know what I mean? And it doesn't really matter how you breathe in. You can breathe in through your nose, your mouth, however you want to do. Okay? So, let's begin. I'm going to lay down. I'm going to put this on my abdomen, and I'm going to breathe. And you can join in with me, and you can breathe along, too, if you want to. Oh yeah, one more thing is, we're going to want to get into like a rhythm with our breathing as if we're sleeping, alright? So that's something else for you to know about this. We're going to want to get into a rhythm like if we're sleeping, and there's a little bit more advanced methods to doing this, like breathing in like from the back of your throat, so it's kind of like, and it's so it's like kind of, you know, but it's breathing in from deep, and you can do that with it on top of that. That's a little bit more advanced, but for this it's super basic. So I'm just gonna do the breathing with you for a few minutes. I don't know how long exactly, but I'm just gonna put this plate on me, and we're gonna do that, and we're gonna get into like a sleep pattern, all right, with our breathing, and get into a sleep pattern with our breathing. And I'm just holding my arms up here so that you can see the pad rise and fall as I breathe. A little weighted. All right, now that was just a short little breathing protocol. I feel pretty charged up right now. All right, I can feel energy in me, and yeah, I'm starting to be able to see energy right now after that session of breathing. The Orgone charging plate is really good for that, and I do recommend it. If you're gonna use weights, you can get them different sizes. I have a friend who makes these, and she does them in different styles. And so, like one like this would probably cost you more, and at this size than a smaller one with like less materials inside. And her name is Trina. She's with let me put this down. The moontree.org. You can buy those charging plates from her. They're called Orgone, and she lives in Canada. So if you live in the United States, the exchange rate makes it really nice. Because Canada's money's not worth as much as the USD. So it's really nice. I spent extra on that one. I gave her the price she wanted for one in USD because her work is so good. But anyways, do that breathing exercise, and I don't know if I explained it at the beginning, so if you got to the end and you're not like feeling the energy in you, you're not, when you breathe in, you're not like exhaling into your lungs and then pushing your stomach out, you're breathing into your stomach. So you're bringing that air in, and you're kind of filling yourself up like a balloon. And so your stomach expands. And you can even just sit and put your hands on your stomach. You know, like if I was gonna be turned sideways or whatever. Here, if I was gonna be turned sideways, you go like. Okay, that's the breathing right there. Yeah, start off with that. And I'll do a video tomorrow. Because I feel like I'm kind of stepping on Sifu Johnny Amen, or Sifu Amen Johnny, his toes with some of the meditations. But there's people out there who are watching my channel that don't follow him. And so I'll just give you a shout out, Sifu Amen Johnny. And like that breathing technique was actually, I learned about it a while ago, but I had a Star Mage Seer even show me that technique too, and reiterate the importance of it. So there's multiple people who know about it. And the technique I'll be showing you tomorrow is more in getting the energy flowing, and then I'll go into the I'll start doing more videos every day. But I'm gonna basically go through Qi Power Plus, the techniques that are in the first book, the first DVD or whatever, because I don't have the advanced techniques, and I want to share it with you guys because there's people out there that want to learn how to cultivate energy, and there's other things from other people that I've learned that help me with cultivating energy that I'll be discussing too. I can actually make this video. I should just, here, you know what? I'm gonna do it right now. All right, so there's another method that people have showed me that really seems to work really well for me. So after you do that there, practice taking that breath in
holding it for as long as you can comfortably in your stomach, and then exhaling. So it's so it's big breaths in, hold it for as long as you can comfortably. Like, don't inhale to the point where you're uncomfortable, but breathe in fully, you know, like get a deep breath into your belly region. Hold it in as long as you can comfortably, and then release it. And keep doing that over and over and over again, and you'll definitely feel the chi in that part. In that breathing exercise, and for the, this is part of the Chi Power Plus, like that technique there wasn't a part of the Chi Power Plus, that was taught to me by, a dude named Panda HP or something like that. He's one of my followers, and he does TK videos and, like, gamer videos and stuff, and, that is very effective. And relax. Don't try to force anything while you're doing it. But this is the second part of that breathing technique that I showed you at the beginning of this video. With breathing in. Like you, it's an audible, so you want to hear this breathing in. It's and you don't necessarily have to, you know what I mean? Or, because you're doing it from down in here and in the in your throat. You're doing it from, you know, your core. You send it out from there, all right? That's more yang, So that's, you force it out, but you can just, so hold on. You know, I'm not, like right there, I tried to force the sound. It's not about forcing the sound. You want to hear the sound, but it's because of how you breathe in. So it's not forced. It's a technique. So you can practice that, and it's like right above your collarbone is where you're going to want to feel that air pulling in from, and it's going down into your belly. And it takes a while of practice to do that, and that's the reason that I showed the charging plate on the abdomen first, because you'll build up muscle memory the more you do it. So if you practice it for a few days like that, with the plate, then it makes it a lot easier to do the audible breathing, and so that you get it down into your abdomen instead of into the lungs. All right, that helped me out a lot with that, and that's why I shared that. And big shout outs to Sifu Amin Johnny, like Star Mage Seer, all of my followers and people watching this, and everybody on their path. I wish you the best of luck in cultivating energy and whatnot. And yeah, give this a shot. It will help you out a lot. Those breathing techniques there. There's a lot more. There's one that I really want to share with you that Trevor Seven gave to me. But I'm not going to do that on this video. It's already pretty long. But Trevor Seven, shout outs to you. And
If you guys really want to learn that technique, Trevor Seven's website is extremely cheap for energy cultivating. And, I mean, it has like 7 videos for you. You can try it, like, you can learn from those 7 videos, and it's only $35, and it's a lifetime, one lifetime fee. And, like, I respect his price on that so much, and like, you can even talk with him and everything else, and, like, have direct communication with him, and he will help you in every way he can help you in, for that $35, and it's a lifetime, one-time fee for a lifetime, so I absolutely recommend you do that. And as a matter of fact, I'm not going to teach you that technique. I might give you bits and pieces of it down the road. But his techniques are really nice. They're amazing. And they do work. Trevor Seven is the most famous, popular, and I want to say successful telekinesis practitioner, teacher on the planet. You know what I mean? Like, you can find Trevor Seven very easy on YouTube or Google. And he's very easy to find, well known. And he has websites. He's the Ormus guy. Trevor Seven is the man. You know what I mean? He's the man. He's the go-to guy. If you guys really need help. And he's got really cheap prices. And he's got enough videos and content online to where if you aren't doing telekinesis and you want to learn telekinesis and you look through his videos and you practice what he's telling you, you know what I mean, then you'll be able to do telekinesis. I'm pretty confident. And if for some reason you can't do telekinesis following what Trevor Seven teaches, then look up Sifu Amen Johnny. Like, him and Trevor Seven are two guaranteed go-to guys that you'll learn everything you need to know about doing telekinesis. Like, the only things I haven't seen there on their channels is tuning. And tuning's when you, like, make sounds for the environment, like ooh, or zzz. If you hear that, and it's because, like, that just helps force energy through your body and get it out into your aura when you zzzz. It's because those vibrations build a lot of pressure inside of yourself and they help you get that out. And so that's why they do that. And when you get your vibrations pushing out into your aura and everything, you know, using sound, your intentions are going with that into your aura, and they're expanding out into the environment, and the environment can choose to co-collaborate with you depending on, like, how the connection you've developed with it and the amount of energy you're putting out, you know what I mean, how much energy you've cultivated in yourself. And because the environment is alive, everything is alive, and this cup with water in it is alive. And I love you. The water, the cup, this cube of ice that's floating in the water is alive. Everything's alive. And this is glass. It's just as alive as you or me. You know what I mean? Like, it might not be walking around eating and, you know, using a bathroom and all that stuff. But it is alive. This glass is alive. You can put, if you develop a connection with it enough, it will help you heal. It will help you heal other people. It will help you in the dream realm. Everything is alive. There's nothing that's not alive. The space in between us is alive. Your screen is alive. You know what I mean? The plants are all alive. Everything's alive. And it's all conscious. By alive, I mean conscious. Because maybe it's not like got a breathing and all that stuff or whatever, but it's conscious. Like, it thinks, just like you and me. It thinks. Alright? This thing is thinking right now. Thought does not come from brains. Alright? Your brains don't think. Your brains hold thoughts. Alright? Like, thoughts come from outside of you and they surround you.
All right. And your brain just happens to have a lot of water in it. It stores a lot of water and it's got a lot of gray matter. And gray matter is your nervous system that like amplifies the retention of memories. All right. And so it holds emotional memories and other types of memories. And it helps hold it, but it's actually all outside of your head. You know what I mean? Your thoughts are all outside of yourself. And so, like, when you're doing energy work, you can pull negative things, you know, and negative memories and traumas off of you as you do your energy work. And you can throw it down and you can let it go because it's not inside of you. It exists outside of you. All right? Your memories and everything like that is outside. It's not inside. And so you can work with all of that and you can get rid of it. You can pull stuff like it's attached to you. The water pulls it to it like a magnet and it holds it and it holds the memories within the water, but it also holds it on the outside of the water. And because the water is like extremely magnetic when it comes to memories and emotions. And so there goes a video. This is getting a lot longer than I planned on it being. Hopefully that helps you out. And tomorrow I will post another one. I'm going to start doing these daily. Do that though. I know I think I'm talking to Sean. I don't look at your name enough to remember it by heart. So I'm sorry about that. But, what you're going to, or Shondell, it might be Shondell or Sean or something like that. But what you're going to want to do, like, give it a shot. Like, even if you don't feel like it resonates with you or whatever, give it a shot. Just give it a chance. Kind of like if you never liked ketchup on a hot dog, just give it a chance. You know, one bite or whatever, you know what I mean? Do a 3-minute session, set a timer. And just, if you don't want to put anything on your stomach, just hold your hands on it and try to fill yourself up like a balloon and don't overdo it. You know what I mean? Just gently take in full breaths. You know, they're full, but they're not so full it hurts yourself. And you're breathing in and you let it out. Into the belly, all right? And that's gonna help you with energy cultivating a lot. And like telekinesis is one thing, but once you learn how to do telekinesis, you can basically do all the other kinesis, as I want to say. Like, I can't guarantee you can do all of them, but you can totally do like aerokinesis once you can do telekinesis. And you can do like electrokinesis and pyrokinesis and hydrokinesis. Once you learn telekinesis, it's all very similar to that. And this breathing technique is not doing telekinesis, but it's going to help you, because when you breathe in, you make yourself able to gravitate things and pull to you. So like, you can pull with your inhale, and you can push with your exhale. So when you breathe in, you're pulling in. When you exhale, you're sending out. Okay. You breathe in, you pull in, you exhale, you push out. That happens naturally. Don't force it. That's why I'm showing you this breathing technique. Do this and it's natural, because your skin is already hollow. Like, your skin breathes. I know there's some like fake science out there and stuff like that that says that skin does not breathe. But that's fake science. There's people that are lying to people, and they might not even know they're lying to people because they might just be really brainwashed and they've never like done the research themselves. But if you like ever study, like if a human being gets covered in oil, like crude oil, what they make gasoline with, they will suffocate and die even if they can breathe through their mouth and their nose. If their skin's covered in it, and it doesn't even honestly need to be all of their skin. They can have just, like, their body covered from their neck down, and they will die if it's covered in oil. And it's not because they're being poisoned. It's because they're being suffocated. Your skin literally breathes in without. So when you breathe in, your skin is already naturally doing it, too. But you can focus on that and make it more intense by learning to exercise the skin breathing muscles. You know what I mean? I don't know what those muscles are called. We have erector pili muscles, and erector pili muscles make the hairs on your skin stand up. And you train those muscles by getting in the cold and by getting in the heat. So like cold showers are, and ice baths are how you exercise your erector pili. And from my knowledge, there's no other way to exercise the erector pili muscles than having temperature shifts. And so you can be a bodybuilder and everything else and not exercise the most abundant muscle in your body, all right? There's strength in many different ways, and we have many different muscles we exercise. And I also recommend you take ice baths. And those are very uncomfortable until, like, especially if you're not doing, like, the breathing protocol. But they're extremely uncomfortable. And so if it doesn't resonate with you, don't do it. But that is amazing for you. At first, it's something that is uncomfortable and it's not pleasant to do. But after you do it for a couple days, it becomes pleasant and somewhat addictive, and it's a good thing to be addicted to, kind of like if you're addicted to doing jumping jacks first thing in the morning, like and then going on a jog or something. Like it's a good thing, it's not a bad thing, it's a good thing. Ice baths are good things. They're just kind of uncomfortable, and it's not really a pleasant thing to endure at first. But once you start doing it, it's hard to live without it. So, yeah, that's this video. Best of luck, to everybody there. I hope you all much success. Namaste.